How's it going, everyone? My name is Fluffly, and today I'm here to help you guys set up PodFarm with your Line 6 UX2 and AT2035, AT2020, AT whatever microphone. So before I get into the basics of this tutorial, I want to mention a few very important things about PodFarm. The first thing I want to mention is that at the top of PodFarm, you'll see gate. And this is your primary noise gate, and you'll have to set it up according to your own, environment. So if you don't want keyboards, if you don't want your fan to show up, you have to increase the threshold to like negative whatever, negative 10 would be an increase. I'll touch more on that later. The second thing I want to mention is that you always want to stay about 2 fists away from your microphone to get the best sound, because if you're too close, you're going to get a lot of plosions and all that noise that no one really wants. The third thing I want to say is that I will link a few bigger YouTubers' microphone settings in the description, including Spoonerism, Tio, Dahi Dinogla, and Tuxbird. However, a little disclaimer with Tuxbird settings, I couldn't get it to sound quite right. But if you do download one of those presets, I'm using Nogla's right now, the noise gate will not transfer, so you still have to set that up by yourself. When you guys get into PodFarm, just click new next to this file explorer icon. And there's 3 primary things that you need for this to work. So you want to go to preamps first and grab American Classic and just drag that into the timeline. Then you want to go to dynamics and right to the right of the first thing that shows up is compressor, and you'll want to put that to the right of American Classic. And then a few more to the right of compressor, you'll find noise gate, and you would want to put it to the left of American Classic. So you should have 3 things on your timeline: noise gate, American Classic, and compressor. So starting with noise gate, I have the threshold set to negative 60. I feel like everyone's threshold should be set to negative 60. This is a secondary noise gate, so if anything gets through your primary noise gate, also make sure that's turned on. The PodFarm decides that it doesn't really want that noise, like a fan or like some static. This secondary noise gate will remove it. And I have the delay set to 67% for both my primary and secondary noise gate. Now, American Classic, you can choose to adjust it or not. You can either leave it default, or you can adjust the top 4 and the bottom 4, so I'm just going to read them out to you. From left to right on top, we have negative 3, negative 3, negative 3, positive 3. And then on the bottom left to right, we have 200, 700, 5000, and 7000. And basically, this just changes the preamp of your voice, so it'll sound more like a radio-type microphone. And then lastly, for compressor, we have the threshold set to negative 33 and the gain set to 8. Now the gain you'll have to adjust on your own accord, but another important thing is that on the actual UX2 itself, you guys will see a mic gain knob. This is the only knob you really need to mess with. And there's 2 that you can choose, either the 4th knob, which is straight up, or the 5th knob, which is it's the first knob to the right of straight up. And the right one would be a little bit louder than how it is now at the 4th knob. So a little extra features I feel like everyone should have in their PodFarm. The first one I would recommend is getting distortions. So I'm just going to click dynamics and I'm going to go left to, and you'll find screamer. Put that directly after American Classic, and then you can leave it as default, but it will be a little loud. So I have it set to 50% for the drive, 30% for the gain, and 50% for the tone. And what a screamer does is it gives you a McDonald's, Wendy's type of microphone sound effect that I know a lot of people really like. So this is why I'm putting it in this video. Another important one, or not really important, a cool feature would be if you go to delays and you go over to, you'll find digital delay. So if you set that just to default, so the time set to 20 milliseconds and then 50% for all the rest, this gives you a little like Optimus Prime voice, or not. It'll give you a robot voice that you can, if you change your voice to match, it can have a lot of cool effects. And then lastly, if you go to dynamics, I believe, let me just check. All right, sorry, there we go. I found it. If you go to reverb and you go over 3, you'll find slap plate. And I have them all just set to default, all at 50%. And this will give you an echo effect like you're being trapped in a well. Now, PodFarm will automatically save your settings, but I highly recommend going up here, hitting save, and then changing the name of your file. But always make sure that you have noise gate, American Classic, and compressor turned on, and they need to be in that order. I hope this video helped you guys out, and if you did, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe. See you guys next time. Peace.